Hi guys and welcome. So we got a how-to video today on our Hikvision DVR. So it's our common DVR we use, and we are gonna set it up straight from scratch. So these are all the settings you should do when you first get your DVR, the initial settings. So we're gonna be talking about the hard drive, we're gonna be running the wizard, talk a little bit about the app, and then we're just going to do some of the basic settings that you should do when you first get your DVR. So it's not just about the wizard, it is a few basic things, and yep, you should, then your DVR should be set up, and you can do some more advanced things later like motion detection, but that's for another day. So let's run through the wizard and quickly talk about what we're doing. So as you see on the screen, we've plugged in our DVR. Okay, so the link for the DVR is below. It's the latest Hikvision AcuSense DVR, and there's a few different ones in the range. The menus should all look the same, but for the older DVRs it might look a bit different, but this is the latest one. Okay, so we are loaded up our DVR. What we have done beforehand is installed a hard drive. So we obviously recommend you get a hard drive if you want to have recording, and there's a link below how to install a hard drive, and that's all we've done, and we've taken it out of the box and plugged it in. So it's a brand new DVR. So let's run through the wizard and yeah, let's get going. Okay, so obviously you want to select your language first things first, and we click on apply. Alright then, so this is the password. It's probably one of the most important stages, if not the most important stage. So just remember not to forget your password. Okay, we'll need a combination of a few letters and numbers. Obviously we're just doing a simple password. We recommend you go for something a bit stronger. Okay, that's all good. Okay, well, we want to click on a reserved email settings, so you can, if you do forget your password, you can put in your email address, and default password, it can be the same as the normal password, SSR CCTV 123. Okay, all right then, so we've set our password. All right, there we go. Okay, password is activated, perfect. So now our device is activated. Okay, we put in our email address. So this is just in case you forget your password and you need to reset it. Password in, email in. Okay, setting succeeded. Okay, this is a pattern, this is a bit more security. So what we're going to do later is disable the password, so you don't have to keep entering a long password in, and you just have a quick pattern to use. So we're going to put in a pattern. They ask you for it twice, run it twice. Okay, now we've set off our basic passwords and security. Now we're gonna, this is stage one of the wizard. Okay, time and date. So this one's pretty straightforward. Select UK time, presuming you're in the UK. Day, month, year, perfect. That's the date. Okay, set the time here. Okie dokie, let's go next. That's the date done. Okay, this is, you don't have to touch anything here. DHCP is enabled, you don't touch that usually. That's what you want. So we go next, don't have to do anything there. Hard disk, okay then. So our hard disk was pre-formatted earlier, but yours might not say normal. So what you have to do is click on the hard drive and click on initialize, INIT. Okay, so I'll initialize the hard drive. Okay, now if it does come up here abnormal, that means, or it says repairing or something like that for a long time, I mean, you could have a faulty hard drive, so do be careful. But if it says normal, then you should all be good and we're ready to rock and roll. All right then, so we go next. Okay, now these are if you want to add on IP cameras. Okay, we have videos on how to do this, but we're not going to talk about IP cameras today. Well, it's found a couple on the network already, so it shows you how easy it is to do if you do have that. Okay, well, we're going to go next. All right, platform access. This is to do with basically getting the app on your phone or remote device. Okay, so there's different ways around this. Quickly show you how to set this part up. But there's two ways around setting up the app, and I'm going to talk about that in a second. Okay, so we want to enable Hik-connect. Okay, verification code. Okay, this is a code that you'll need to enter in when you set up the app. So basically, it stops other people downloading the app, and if they don't have this code, they won't be able to access your stuff. So we're just going to put in the same SSR CCTV 1, 2, 3. Okay. Okay, and we click on OK. All right, so our self-verification code sent, just set. Oh, okay, as you see, we've got two codes here. So what are the two codes? One is a serial number for your DVR. So you will need that in order to add the DVR to your app. Okay, and the other one is for the app. Now, you can download, if you've got a QR reader, you can scan the code right here now and set up an account. We recommend don't go to visitor mode. Visitor mode is fine, but we recommend you register an account with your phone number or email address. It's much better that way. Okay, but if you don't want to set up register account on your phone, maybe you're not a phone person, we have got a link right below on how to set up the app using your PC. Now, if you set up using your PC, it is really easy to set up and share the app. And you see all the settings there, and you can customize how to share it. So there's two ways. One right here is scan the code and download the app and just run through the wizard on the app. It's really easy. Or two, look at the link below how to set up the app. Okay, so that should answer most questions here. So we're going to go next now. Okay, we don't want to set a new password, so we go finish. All right, okay, well, there I am. Let's get out of this mode. All right, first things first, we are going to upgrade the firmware. All right, you don't have to do this, but especially if you have got audio cameras, I know there's a little update on the firmware to help out with the audio here, so I recommend always update to the latest firmware. Now, it's really, really easy to do nowadays. There is a direct link below to how to update this DVR. But I got a full guide as well how to update it. All you need is a USB memory stick. It's very easy. So we've got down here, upgrade. So I've already plugged in my USB earlier, and it's all ready to go. So we select the file here, and we click on upgrade. Okay, yes please. So now we're going to upgrade our DVR. All right, it's just to make sure we've got the latest firmware. There's no little bugs or anything like that. It is recommended. You don't have to do this often, but especially if you're setting up, you might as well do it properly. Okay, and now it's upgrading, so it will cut out very soon on my feed, and we're going to start again from the main menu, and I'll catch you in a minute. Thanks. All right then, so we're back now on our restarted DVR. I just put in English again. Don't worry, don't have to go through that everything again. Okay, don't forget your pattern. Okay, we're back in our DVR. Okay, we can exit the wizard this time because we've already set it all up. Okay, now what I'm going to do show you quickly is how to disable this wizard so it doesn't keep asking us. We go top right corner and maintenance right here. Okay. Oh no, sorry, system. So system, we can now disable the wizard, and I don't like the password to keep coming up. I know we're on here, it's all good. So now our password is disabled. It's not going to keep asking us every 2 minutes for the password. Okay. All right then. So let's start off with some basic settings right here. Okay. So first things first is you want to set your resolution. What it will do is by default set it to the lowest resolution possible. So this is just for compatibility issues. It doesn't give a very nice picture quality, and so you can go up to 4K on this DVR, but our monitor is only 1080p, so we're going to select 1080p and click on apply. Okay, now we've set our resolution. Not much else to do on this menu. We can change the name of the DVR. You might have multiple DVRs, so you might want at home, one at office, so we're just going to call this office DVR. Okay, we can apply that. Okay, so now we are going to also look at, okay, so I don't know if you've heard this in the background, is beeping going on. So beeping is usually one of two reasons. One, what I'm going to explain to you in a minute, and two is the most common reason is a faulty hard drive. But I know our hard drive is not faulty, so what is the beeping? Okay, so what Hikvision have done on the new DVRs is they have activated motion detection as default. And what happens is when it detects motion, it's going to beep. So I don't know if you saw me earlier on the camera, but it's detecting me and beeping away. So what we're going to do is get rid of this. Okay, so we go to camera. I know we were in the right place already. We go to event here on the left. Okay, now we find our camera. Okay, so it's detecting me and activating motion. As you can see, it's already enabled. And if you go to the linkage action, linkage means what's going to happen after detection. It's an audible warning. Okay, that basically means DVR beeping. So what we're going to do is disable this now. So we click on unenable, apply, copy to. Now if you have multiple cameras here, just click on here and go okay, apply. Now it's going to disable all the motion detection on all the cameras. Okay, so later on, if you do want to set it up, all you have to do is just make sure you set up the linkage. Most people probably want no device surveillance center, which means your app, to get a notification. So there's loads of videos on motion detection, please check them out later, but we're just doing some basic settings here on our DVR. All right then, so what we are going to do now is just look at a few basic camera settings. So we go to camera here, and we've got on the left here, we've got display. Okay, so for start off with, we can change the camera name. It's going to call this office camera, office do for now. Okay, so I know this is one of the office. We'll go and check back. Okay, the settings. Okay, I prefer to have it day, month, year. We just change that to day, month, year. Image settings. Okay, so the mode is standard. Okay, there's nothing wrong with standard mode, but you've got indoor mode, outdoor mode, dim light. We're just going to select indoor. Click on apply. Okay, parameter settings. Okay, this is means 5 megapixel. We're using a 5 megapixel camera. Perfect. Please note, some 5 megapixel cameras from Hikvision might be set to 4, so please check here that you're not set to 4 or 1080p, just set it to 5 and you get the highest possible resolution. Okay. Alright, so these are video parameters. What do we want to do here? Okay, as you can see, it comes preset now, cameras to have video and audio. So a lot of cameras nowadays will have AOC, which is audio over coax or cable, and you get the audio built in. But if you do not have audio cameras, what we recommend here is to do is to disable it. So we go video and audio source, we just go local audio. Okay, now we click on apply. So this is going to make sure you're not getting any wasted recording for audio or anything like that. Okay, and do the same for the substream as well. So substream, you see it has audio, so we go here and go apply. Okay, obviously if you do have an audio camera, you don't have to touch it nowadays, it will come preset to listen. So okay, I think that covers basically most of our topics. We're just going to have one last look at compression. So this is our hard drive. As you can see, it's set to record continuously 24/7, and if you do want to increase the capacity, we go back to our video parameters here. And you'll see, yep, it's at 5 megapixel. Enable H265 plus. Okay, so this, if we enable this on our camera and click on apply, we will have to reboot, so I'm not going to do this just yet. But once you've enabled this, you can save up to at least 33% more storage space. So this is a great thing to access to enable if you do want to have more storage or you have a small hard drive. Okay then, so we're going to click on yes. But that's basically how to spec the basic settings of a DVR, the latest one from Hikvision, AcuSense. I hope you guys learn how to best set it up, and you should have no problems now moving forward when all the basic settings are done. So I hope you guys enjoyed that, and hopefully see you in some more advanced videos later. Thank you, bye, cheers.